Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we are diving into a critical aspect of database management, that is activating SQL Server Authentication in your local database using SQL Server Management Studio, or SSMS for short. Now you might be wondering, why would I need to use SQL Server Authentication instead of just sticking with Windows Authentication? Imagine this. You are developing an application that needs to connect to an SQL Server database. This application will be deployed on different servers, possibly even accessed by users outside the organization. Relying solely on Windows authentication could be limiting or even impossible in this scenario. Aside from that, when you have your API running as an image in Docker, Docker does not support Windows authentication. So in this case, you need to use SQL Server Authentication. Now, SQL Server Authentication offers a flexible and secure way to manage database across different environments. And you know, in this video, I'm going to guide you step by step on how to enable this and why it is a must known for any developer or database admin. So let's get started. I have my SQL database installed already. I also have my SSMS installed. But if you haven't installed any of these, then I have the links in there. I'll put them in the video description. You can download them and install for free. These are the links. So you can see that from here, if you want to download the SSMS, that is the SQL Server Management Studio. There's a link, and click on this to get it downloaded. If you want to also download the SQL Server database, then there's a link, and you can download developer version or even an Express version. I'll put the links in there. So if you're able to install the SSMS, that is what you're going to have a look at it. So this is the interface, and as soon as I get connected, I'm going to see my database that I have installed using the SQL Server. So this is the database that I have in here. Great. So now that we have this installed, let's move on with that. Now, for a default or Windows authentication, it's going to use the credential that you have set on your Windows. So in this scenario, you don't need to connect to any user ID or password. But let's assume you want to skip this and you want to use the SQL Server authentication. How are you going to do it? Now let's see this. So we are back to the interface, and as soon as you select the SQL Server authentication, you can see we have a login. You need to provide login, you need to provide password. If you decide not to provide any of this and I hit on connect, you're not going to be connected because this requires a login properties or credentials. How do we do this? In order for you to authenticate using SQL Server, first, what you need to do here is go to the normal authentication, go to Windows authentication, and it is through that Windows authentication you can set up the SQL Server authentication. So first thing first, get it connected. When you are done, in this case, there is a server, that's a desktop, ULD, and etc. There's a server in here. I click on the server and I go to properties. Now, under the properties, what do you need to do again? All that you need to do is go to security. And now here you can see we have server authentication. So this is the first thing that you must do. Make sure you have this SQL Server and Windows authentication mode checked. So it means you want to support SQL Server authentication as well, as far as Windows authentication too. Good. Now, when you are done with that, click on OK to get this saved. The next thing that we're going to do here is to go to security, and you see we have login. So with this login, when you open it, you see we have an SA, that is a system administrator. That's the default login. You can create a new one by clicking on this login and then go to new login and providing all the necessary data that you need in here. So if it is an SQL Server authentication, then click on that and provide the name and then the password. So you have a login name, the password, now you confirm the password, and I click on OK. You're done with that. But since you have a default one already set, we don't want to do that. Let's go and edit what we have. That's the default one, and which is known as the SA System Administrator. So click on that, and in here, you can see we have the login name already. That is an SA. And there is a password. So for the password, I'm going to change this to maybe root. And I'll change this to root. After that, I'll make sure for default database, you can leave it or you can just make it to the, set it to the master. That's the default one. And when you're done, you come to status. Now from this status, you see from here, we have permission to connect database engine. Granted, and I log in. Enable this. When you're done, go to server room and now make sure you activate public and our system admin. When you're done with this, you are through. That's great. Very simple one. You're done. All right. So in order for you to check whether this is working or not, you need to disconnect and I reconnect. Disconnect here and I'll let's connect it. Choose now no more SQL Window Authentication. Go to SQL Server Authentication. Login name is SA. Password is root, and I'll click on connect, and now we are in. So you can see that here we have our databases, and now if you are working with a Docker connected to a database, local database, which will be required to provide a user ID and password, or if you are running your application in any environment whereby you want user to also get access to this, then all that you need to do here is to provide the user ID and the password. And you're good to go. And there you have it. Activating SQL Server Authentication is just that simple. By enabling this, you have opened up a more flexible and secure way to manage access to your database, especially in scenarios where your application or users aren't tied to your local Windows domain. Whether you are working with a remote team, deploying applications in the cloud, or just need more granular control over database access, SQL Server Authentication is a powerful tool in your toolkit. If you found this video or this tutorial helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button for more tips and tricks. If you have any question or run into any issue, drop a comment below and I'm here to help. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.